Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about a reflected XSS, typical examples of such attacks, and best practices to prevent the underlying vulnerabilities. So let's get started. What are cross-site scripting vulnerabilities? Cross-site scripting is a client-side application security vulnerability that allows the adversary to manipulate user interactions with a web server application. In violation of the same origin policy, attackers exploit insecure input interfaces and client-side scripting to execute malicious code. While doing so, the victim is tricked into visiting the page with a malicious script so that the executable code is delivered to the victim's browser. In such attacks, hackers also masquerade as compromised users to access the victim's data and carry out actions with their permission. In instances where the victim is a privileged access user, attackers can fully compromise the application's data and functionality. Any application not validating the user input when generating script outputs is vulnerable to XSS attacks. XSS attacks are generally categorized as stored, persistent XSS, reflected attacks, DOM-based XSS. Reflected, non-persistent XSS attacks occur when the malicious payload is included in the request sent to the vulnerable web application and is then reflected such that the server's HTTP response consists of the payload. Attackers leverage social engineering techniques such as phishing attacks to make the victim include the malicious script in their request to the web server. The victim's browser then executes the malicious script as the HTTP response. Reflected XSS attacks are non-persistent such that each victim needs to send the request with a malicious payload. As a result, attackers tend to trick as many users as possible to succeed in the attack. Such attacks are often aimed at message form submissions, error messages, or search engine results pages, as it is easier to craft a malicious email message that many users can click on. As one of the most common types of XSS attacks, reflected XSS does not require the attacker to locate and access a vulnerable web application that would allow them to inject malicious scripts permanently. A reflected XSS attack is a commonly exploited form of XSS vulnerability. Organizations should leverage common prevention mechanisms to prevent the reflected cross-site scripting vulnerabilities in web applications. Reflected cross-site scripting prevention. Protection against reflected XSS primarily involves avoiding using dynamic malicious content from HTTP requests to embed scripts on a vulnerable application. Some approaches to achieve this include: validate user input. User input validation content filtering forms the first line of defense against most XSS attacks, including reflected XSS. It is essential to treat a user input from any source as untrusted and formulate mechanisms to check against semantic and grammatical requirements. Security teams should also apply whitelists, blacklists for data patterns that should be accepted or rejected. Additionally, it is recommended that QA and administration teams treat data from both authenticated and public users as untrusted inputs, while applying the same input sanitization techniques across all users. Escape dynamic content. Suppose the application relies on user-controllable data as part of its HTTP responses. In that case, the output data should be encoded so that the server does not interpret it as active content. This ensures that any special characters from the application's data store are treated as HTML tag content and not raw HTML. It is recommended to replace any significant dynamic characters with Hangul entity encoding schemes to be interpreted safely. Developers should use dedicated tools to enable a safe stylesheet and script encoding if dynamic content is inserted into the script and style tags. Implement a content security policy. A robust content security policy lets web administrators developers control where the web page can load and execute scripts from. Since reflected XSS attack relies on the attacker embedding malicious content on a web page, CSPs prevent attacks by specifying the sources of inline scripts. Developers instruct browsers using a content security policy header or meta element, including directives for sources and sinks of specific resources and actions. Web developers can whitelist allowed sources of trusted scripts using the code example shown in the video. This directive allows for the trusted execution of scripts from the server hosting the current page and those originating from https://darwin.com. Most modern browsers support CSPs, making them one of the most crucial aspects of preventing reflected XSS attacks. Utilize a vulnerability scanning tool. Vulnerability scanning tools automatically test web applications and underlying source code to identify security gaps that can lead to the successful execution of XSS attacks. The Crashtest Security Suite includes an XSS tool that can scan JavaScript and web applications for vulnerabilities such as XSS with no false positives. Following are some common approaches attackers leverage to carry out reflected XSS attacks. Reflected XSS attack on a search query. Assume a web app accepts a search string from users through a search parameter within a query string, as shown in the video. In the event, the application server uses PHP to show the user-supplied value on the results page by pulling it from the URL and then generating the resulting HTML shown here. The web server directly parses the user-supplied value in the URL to HTML with no input validation or output encoding. In such instances, attackers can craft arbitrary code that is executed in the browser when the victim clicks on the URL shown in the video. His script gives hackers access to the user's session cookie and allows them to assume a legitimate user's identity. Reflected XSS attack on an error message. Suppose a web page accepts an input parameter that contains the text displayed in an error message and displays it directly within its response. In that case, attackers use such vulnerabilities to orchestrate XSS attacks. Assuming the URL that returns the error message as the code shown in the video. The returned error page directly copies the values of the URL's message parameter and then displays it suitably within the page. Without sanitization or appropriate validation, attackers can create a malicious payload to generate a pop-up screen. If an unsuspecting user requests this page, the browser executes the malicious script, redirecting the user to an handle page with the following content in place of the actual content. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.